Dear students, I am Shiva, faculty of physics. In this episode, we are going to discuss one important concept for 8th standard students, that is time period for the dipole. In the last session, we discussed about the potential energy of the dipole. Let us try to consolidate the ideas of the potential energy of the dipole one more time. So here, we are seeing one situation where the dipole, okay, this is the dipole having the dipole moment P bar oriented at an angle theta with horizontal. This dipole now further rotated in this manner such that the dipole again making same angle theta but in the downward direction. So at that time the electric field applied to this dipole is E bar in the upward direction. Now question here for us, calculate the change in the potential energy, work done by the external torque as well as the work done by the electrostatic force. So first of all, let us try to calculate what is the change in the potential energy for the dipole when the dipole now changes its angular position from minus theta to plus theta. So why here I am saying minus theta, this is clockwise direction angle. This is anti-clockwise direction. That's why when the dipole orientation changes from minus theta to plus theta, what is the change in potential energy? So first of all, what is the general expression? General expression for potential energy, U is equal to minus PE cos theta, where theta indicates angle between P and E. So suppose if I label this is initial as well as this is final, then what is UY? So UY is equal to minus PE cos of, so what is the angle between this P bar and E bar? This is totally 90, okay. So out of the 90 degrees, here you are seeing theta there removed now. So what is that remaining angle? Remaining angle now 90 degrees minus theta. Nothing but here what we can write, 90 degrees minus theta. So it will become minus PE sin theta. Why? Cos of 90 minus theta is equal to the sin theta. Okay, next this is final case. Now again, what is UF? UF is equal to minus PE. Okay, what is the angle between this final orientation of the P bar with E bar? So from here to here 90, again this further angle theta. Now what is the total angle between E bar to P bar? This is 90, this is theta. Totally it will become 90 plus theta. Now we can write cos of 90 degrees plus theta. So what is cos of 90 plus theta? That is minus sin theta. Now we can write this one plus PE sin theta. Okay. So what is the delta U now? So delta U we can write UF minus UY. So what is the value for UF? PE sin theta minus of, what is the value for UY? Minus PE sin theta. So it will become totally 2PE sin theta. Okay. So 2PE sin theta is what for us? Change in the electrostatic potential energy when the dipole now move from this orientation, that is minus theta orientation, to plus theta orientation. Okay. Now here what is the work done by the, first of all we can calculate what is the work done by the electrostatic force. Now already we know delta U is equal to minus W, nothing but the change in the potential energy always equal to the negative of the work done by the conservative force. Here in our case that conservative force is electrostatic force, that's why what we can write W is equal to minus delta U. Delta U we are already calculated as 2PE sin theta. nothing but work done by the electrostatic force now will become for us minus 2p sin theta. Okay, again asking for us what is the work done by the external force. So work done by the external force now we can write as according to work and kinetic energy theorem. So observe here. So what is the state of the dipole in this orientation? That is kinetic energy initially zero. Okay. So what is the state of the dipole in this orientation? In this state also the kinetic energy is zero. Nothing but according to work and kinetic energy theorem here, what we can write? Work done by the electrostatic force plus work done by the applied force is equal to change in the kinetic energy. So change in the kinetic energy implies Kf minus Ki will become zero. Okay. So what is the work done by the applied force now? So work done by the applied force is equal to negative. Now this minus W electrostatic force I am sending there. It will become negative of the work done by the electrostatic force. So work done by the electrostatic force already you are seeing now minus 2p sin theta. So it will become minus of minus 2p sin theta. Simply it will become plus 2pe sin theta. Okay. Now what are the answers here? Change in the potential energy. So 2p sin theta. Then change in the work done by the electrostatic force minus 2p sin theta. Work done by the applied force 2p sin theta. Okay. Now come to the prerequisite, that is rotational inertia. So what do you mean by rotational inertia? So rotational inertia is nothing but the inability of the body in order to change its state from rest to motion. So already in mechanics part, Newton's laws of motion we know, na? Inertia. At that time inertia means what we discussed. Inertia is the inability of the body to change its state from rest to motion. So mass is the measure of the inertia, na? Nothing but for any object if mass is more, that object can't be able to change its state from rest to motion and motion to rest. Otherwise even that motion also it is not possible to convert from accelerated to decelerated, otherwise decelerated to accelerated, as well as all of these two uniform. In the same pattern, if the rotational inertia also gives some opposition to change its state, if I value more, we can't be able to change the state from rotational motion to for any other thing. Otherwise, if I is less, easily we can change the state of the motion from rotational to other. So here, this rotational inertia we can label with this letter I. Okay. So now I is what for us? I is measure of resistance. Measure of resistance to oppose change in motion. To oppose change in motion. Okay, how can we calculate this value of I? Okay, one more name for rotation inertia only we can say as moment of inertia. How can we calculate this I? Suppose this is rotational axis. From this rotational axis you are seeing some particles. Okay, so here I am showing m1, m2, m3. M1 lies at r1 perpendicular distance from this rotational axis. M3 lies at r3 perpendicular distance. M2 lies at r2 perpendicular distance. All of these particles what we are seeing now, m1, m2, m3, these are what type of particles? Discrete particles. At that time, what is the expression for the rotational inertia? Rotational inertia, simply we can say it is the summation of product of mass and its perpendicular distance and the square of the perpendicular distance from the rotational axis. Sum of product of the mass and square of its perpendicular distance from the rotational axis. Okay, use this expression of what we can write here. I is equal to m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus m3 r3 square. Okay, now this is I am saying for what type of particle system. This is the expression for discrete particle system. Discrete particle system. Suppose instead of discrete particle system, if you are taking any continuous mass distribution, okay, suppose this is, I am saying, one mass. So what is the name for this type of mass distribution? This is continuous mass distribution. Okay, so for this type of continuous mass distribution, then what is the expression to calculate the rotational inertia? I is equal to integral r square into dm. Okay, so I hope these concepts you are familiar in your previous sessions, and we studied these topics under rotational mechanics. What time go and revise that concepts. Okay, so this is the expression for discrete particle system. This is the expression for continuous mass distribution. Okay, now let us recall some ideas, some definitions from rotational mechanics. Again. Now I am talking all of these are for what type of rotational motion, that is fixed axis. Okay, so in rotational motion about fixed axis, how can we define L? L implies angular momentum. L defines angular momentum, that is momentum of momentum. So L is equal to I omega implies L bar is equal to I bar I ka I into omega bar. As well as here we can define net external torque. So how can we define net external torque? Net external torque is equal to rate of change of angular momentum. Rate of change of angular momentum. So angular momentum L, its rate of change is d by d of L. So again, what is L here? L is equal to I omega. That's why we can write d by dt of I omega. So again, I constant na, for any given mass distribution. So I into d omega by dt. So nothing but tau net is equal to I alpha. This is one important definition in rotational mechanics for the motion of the object about what axis? About fixed axis. Okay. So again here you are observing, na, I am writing alpha is d omega by dt. Nothing but what do you mean by alpha here? Alpha indicates angular acceleration. What is alpha? Angular acceleration. So how can we define the angular acceleration? Alpha is equal to d omega by dt. D omega by dt. That is rate of change of angular velocity. Okay, further, omega, omega implies here what for us? Angular velocity. How can we define the angular velocity? Instantaneously I am talking about, angular velocity is equal to d theta by dd. Okay, so further, how can we define the alpha? Alpha is equal to d omega by dd. Now write down in the place of omega d theta by dt. Again what we can write? D by dt of d theta by dt. So nothing but here simply what we can write? D square theta by dt square. D square theta by dt square. Nothing but observe this, the definitions again carefully. L indicates angular momentum. So what do you mean by angular momentum? angular momentum L is equal to I omega. So net torque is equal to rate of change of angular momentum. So rate of change of angular momentum is simply equal to what for us? I alpha for what type of axis motion? That is fixed axis rotation. Again, alpha is equal to rate of change of angular velocity. Later, angular velocity is equal to rate of change of angular position. So again, angular acceleration, how can we define? Second derivative of angular displacement with respect to the time. Okay, so first derivative of angular velocity with respect to the time also angular acceleration. Second derivative of angular position with respect to the time also angular acceleration. Okay, now let us talk about one more important prerequisite here, angular simple harmonic motion. So what do you mean by simple harmonic motion? If any motion, the force always trying to regain the object's position to its initial one, as well as that force is directly proportional to the displacement but opposite in direction, that type of motion we can say simple harmonic motion. Okay, simple harmonic motion is nothing but the motion where the force is directly proportional to the displacement and its direction is opposite to the direction of the displacement. At that time, that motion is said to be what type of motion? Simple harmonic motion. Suppose that simple harmonic motion we can say as linear or angular. Suppose we can talk about this type of simple harmonic motion, that is angular simple harmonic motion. So what is the example? Suppose you can take the example as simple pendulum. Okay, this is simple pendulum. If you disturb the bob from its mean position, then that bob now starts to oscillate. Okay, this one example for simple harmonic motion, that is angular motion. Again, you have one thread or string. From that thread or string, we have suspended one disc-like object. Okay, disc-like object like this we have suspended. If you rotate this disc in this horizontal plane like this, and you can release again, it will move back. This motion will continue further. Nothing but it will move in clockwise and anti-clockwise directions continuously if there is no air around it. Okay, if either exists, it is not simple harmonic motion, it will become damped. But here I am saying simple harmonic motion, this motion will continue. Okay, in order to conserve mechanical energy. Okay, whatever we know, what is the equation for the angular simple harmonic motion? Now here we can write d square theta by dt square plus omega square theta is equal to 0. So this is general equation. What type of equation? General equation of angular SHM, simple harmonic motion. So what is the value for omega here? So omega now we can write as square root of k by a. K indicates constant, I indicates rotational inertia. What is I here? Rotational inertia. Okay, so remember this equation. This is the equation for angular simple harmonic motion, d square theta by dt square plus omega square theta. Theta indicates angular position, omega indicates some constant, that omega we can write as square root of k by I. Okay, now come to this case. Here you are seeing one dipole. This is minus q, this is plus q, and previously electric field is applied in this direction. That's why this dipole now orient in what direction? This dipole orients in the direction of the E bar. dipole now oriented in what direction? In the direction of E1. Now we are making or we are disturbing the dipole from its equilibrium position. What type of equilibrium position? In the previous topic that we discussed, na, when the dipole orientation is same as the direction of the electric field, at that time the equilibrium regarding to this configuration is stable. When the orientation of the dipole is opposite to the direction of the electric field, at that time the equilibrium regarding to that configuration is unstable. In this present situation, P bar direction rightward, E bar direction also rightward. That's why this configuration is an example for stable equilibrium. Now we are making the dipole or we are displacing the dipole from its stable equilibrium. This is the configuration of what equilibrium? Stable equilibrium. Now we are disturbing the dipole from its stable equilibrium by what angle? By the angle theta. If this is theta, this is also theta. So, but one condition here, we are disturbing this dipole in a manner such that where the theta value is restricted to 5 degrees. So, why the theta is less than or equal to 5 degrees? In this region of the angle, that is from 0 degrees to 5 degrees, the value of the sinusoidal function of theta is approximately equal to theta. The value of tangent of theta is approximately equal to theta. Similarly, the cosine function of theta will become approximately equal to 1. Nothing but sinusoidal, tangent as well as cosine functions will become simple linear functions according to this approximation. At that time, the motion has a chance to become simple harmonic and we are allowed to apply this expression. That's why I am assuming the angle theta is limited to less than or equal to 5 degrees. Okay, now I am disturbing in this manner from a stable equilibrium position and I am moving the dipole from this location. Then there what will happen? We can see the situation looks like in this manner. So this is plus Q, minus Q, again this plus Q comes here, again this minus Q goes here, here also what is the angle theta, here also what is the, sorry this is not angle, here only. So this is the angle theta as well as this is also what is the angle for us, theta. Now theta we are assuming there less than or equal to 5 degrees. Now in the previous session, we derived the expression for torque acting on the dipole. So what is the torque acting on the dipole now here? P sin theta. So, but I am keeping minus sign here. Why? As theta decreases, tau they are acting in the direction that is opposite to the direction of the decreasing theta. Suppose here tau is decreasing in this pattern. Na? At that time, tau will act in what direction? Tau will act in the direction that is opposite to theta. That's why here I am using minus sign to indicate that point. Okay, here theta we are taking less than or equal to 5 degrees. Na? So theta there less than or equal to 5 degrees. What is tau? Tau is equal to minus P theta. So what is the equation for tau? Tau already there we studied na, in prerequisite part. Tau net is equal to I alpha. I alpha now we can say P theta. So what is alpha here? Alpha is equal to minus P by I into theta. Okay. So now, so what is alpha again? So alpha now for us d omega by dt that is equal to minus P by I into theta. So what is omega? Omega there d theta by dt. Na? D theta by dt is equal to minus P E by I into theta. So what is the result of this one? This one now we can write as d square theta by dt square is equal to minus P I by I into theta. Again it will become d square theta by dt square plus PE by I into theta is equal to 0. Now compare this equation with angular dissection. We know that. So what is the equation of angular dissection? The equation of the angular dissection is this one. Na? Now what we can write? D square theta by dt square plus omega square theta is equal to 0 for what type of dissection? For angular dissection. Okay? Now compare here carefully. What is omega square? Omega square is equal to PE by I. Okay? So omega square is equal to PE by I. Nothing but omega will become square root of PE by I. Now what is time period here? So time period we can define as 2 pi by omega. So if you substitute here, this expression will become T pi square root of I by PE. Okay? So T is equal to 2 pi into square root of I by PE is the expression for the time period of dipole when it was disturbed by a small angle theta from its stable equilibrium. Okay, once you know time period, we are able to calculate natural frequency now. So what is the expression for the natural frequency? If you calculate the time period after the calculation of the time period, you can calculate the natural frequency f as the reciprocal of this time period. Again you can calculate the angular frequency, that is omega is equal to 2 pi f. So once you know f, again you can calculate omega also. Okay, so this is the expression for time period. From this expression of the time period, you can calculate angular frequency as well as natural frequency. Okay, now we can see one example in order to confirm this illustration. So assume yourself you have some support. Okay, so from this support, by using a string, we are suspending one light rod. At both ends of the light rod, we are attaching two charges. One is minus Q, another one is plus Q. And the region is filled with the electric field in this direction. Okay? What is the situation here? This is some support. From that support, with the help of string, you are suspending one light rod. At both ends of the light rod, you are seeing the two charges are attached. One is minus Q, another one is plus Q. This system we are keeping well in the electric field. Okay, now at the time of electric field, do you expect any motion to this rod containing these two charges? No. Why? This rod also clearly in what type of equilibrium now? Stable equilibrium. Why? The rod dipole moment P bar also coincides with E bar. That's why there is no motion regarding to dipole initially. But if you are rotating this one in this manner, slightly now I am rotating like this. Okay. Suppose I am rotating in this plane only, in this manner. This is minus Q, this is plus Q. But I am rotating on different plane. I am rotating in this horizontal plane only like this. Okay. So at that time there what will happen, once you rotate this well by the angle theta and again you can do it, it will experience what type of motion? It will experience oscillatory motion. That oscillatory motion, again what type of oscillatory motion? That is the dipole exhibits angular dissection. Now question here, what is the time period of the dipole? What is the time period of dipole? So in order to calculate the time period of the dipole, we can utilize this expression here again. As well as assume now here, this charge also having the mass m, this charge also having the mass m. So even here minus q some electrons are added, this electron's mass is negligible when compared with this original mass. That's why this point represents what a COM. Okay. So what is the problem now? We have one support. From that support, we are hanging one dipole, but the dipole this time containing two charges that are attached to the light rod, as well as the two charges are having equal mass. Now we are disturbing the dipole from its equilibrium position. Like that, you are rotating the dipole by an angle theta in the horizontal plane. After leaving it, the dipole exhibits some simple harmonic motion. What is the time period of that simple harmonic motion? That is the question. In order to calculate the time period of the simple harmonic motion, now you are using this formula. That is, t is equal to 2 pi into square root of I by PE. Okay, so what is I here? So here you are seeing two masses, na? This is one mass, this is another mass. So this is M, this is also M. Say the distance between the two are L, nothing but this COM now lies at what distance? This COM lies at L by 2 from here, as well as L by 2 from here. Now what is the value for I about this COM? I will become ml square by 4 plus ml square by 4, it will become ml square by 2. Okay, so what is the value for P again here? So P will become Q into, that is the charge on, that is the magnitude of the either charge, into distance between them. Distance between them I assume as L, now it is QL. So P value also QL. Now one might substitute this I value, this P value in this expression. Now what we can write? T is equal to 2 pi square root of, what is the value for I? I is equal to ml square by 2. What is the P value here? P value there QL into E. Okay. So again we can write, this is 2 pi square root of ml divided by 2eq. So this is the expression for the time period of this light rod containing two charges executing the hanger simple harmonic motion in what plane? Horizontal plane. Okay students, in this session what we studied? We studied one simple problem in order to consolidate the ideas of previous video. Okay, so there one orientation given, that is the dipole initially oriented in this manner, thereafter it is rotated further in this pattern. At that time, what is the change in delta U? What is the work done by the external force? What is the work done by the electrostatic force? Later, we studied about a little bit rotation inertia. And what is the formula to calculate the rotational inertia for discrete mass distribution? What is the formula to calculate the rotational inertia for continuous mass distribution? Later, we studied about definitions of angular momentum, net external torque, angular acceleration, angular velocity for the rotational motion about what axis? Fixed axis. Again, we tried to understand the general equation of angular simple harmonic motion. Okay, that is d square theta by dt square plus omega square into theta. Later, we derived an expression for the time period of dipole when the dipole is disturbed by an angle theta from its vertical equilibrium position, stable equilibrium position. We got the expression t is equal to 2 pi square root of I by PE. Later, we applied this equation to one simple situation where we have the light rod containing two charges exhibiting simple harmonic motion. At that time, what is the time period of this light rod? Okay, so this is today's lecture, students. I hope you understood this lecture well. In the next episode, we will meet with one more new concept. Thank you for watching.